Hello, folks, and welcome to the initial broadcast of Media Done Right from Meteorite Marketing. This is a little interview show where we talk to people that we find interesting. How about that? And a band that I discovered online is doing great justice, paying great respect to my favorite all-time band. You can see it on the t-shirt here. We are very delighted to welcome in the lead vocalist of Lone Star Skynyrd, Stephen Naylor. Stephen?
Hey, Jim. How you doing, man? Thank you so much for having me on the show.
Yep. Great to see you. We are thrilled to have you here. Folks, I have been a diehard Skynyrd fan since 74 when I saw him in Philadelphia at the JFK concert that Peter Frampton headlined. And I'll never forget it. And I've been a fan ever since. Listen to him virtually every day. Know every lyric. Could sing every song to you. But because I like all of you folks, I won't do that. But I am knocked out, Stephen, by what you and the band do. And we want to talk about that a little bit and give folks a little flavor of Lone Star Skynyrd and how well you're honoring this music. And we'll talk about how you're exactly like the record and a lot more. So a lot of musical samplings here of Lone Star Skynyrd. And first off, let's tell everyone that you won a very rigorous award competition called the International Josie Music Awards. And I want to hear about that. But this wasn't, tell your friends to just text a popularity contest vote in to win this, right?
No, not at all. Wasn't a little rinky-dink contest. It was held at the Grand Ole Opry House in Nashville. Like you said, it's an international competition set up like the Grammys or something, different categories. Tribute Band of the Year was one, and we took that thing home. But it's really good award ceremony, done right, you know, and to get up on that stage and accept an award for something, you know, we did, and Tribute Band of the Year. God, there's nothing like it, man.
Being on the stage of the Grand Ole Opry had to be incredible for you.
Yeah, man. Very cool. Next, my kid's being born. One of the coolest things ever.
That's fantastic. The band must have been fired up about that.
Oh, yeah. We was all excited, man.
I'm going to guess you don't plan on giving up this award when the competition rolls around again. This is an annual award.
You don't give up that trophy, do you? We're going
to
go back. We're going to be the first band to win it 2 times in a row.
Fantastic. So I believe, and I bet you do, and I know a lot of people out there believe as well, that Lynyrd Skynyrd was all set to become the American band, the finest American band going, until that damn plane on 10/20/77 changed everything. And so you had the opportunity. You have incredible musicians with you. It's easy to see that. Why not be just another cover band of somebody else? Why Lynyrd Skynyrd?
Skynyrd is, for one thing, I love Lynyrd Skynyrd, have since I was, you know, a little kid. And it's timeless music. It, reaches from 8 years old to 85 years old. And it's just timeless, classic music.
Tell me about that 80-some-year-old fan you talked about.
Yeah, her name's Johnny Martin. We'll say, hey, Johnny, how you doing? Johnny. But she is. She saw us at a venue out in Irving, Texas. It was a barbecue cook-off in Texas, of course. And we played out there, and she discovered us there and fell in love with the band, wanted a shirt, part of a little duo, her and her friend, the Dancing Grannies. And so she's going to be our guest at our next show, too. So
fantastic. Well, before we go any further, let's give everybody a little sampling of how Lynyrd Skynyrd lives on with the incredible respect and the dedication that you guys give to every song. But we'll start off with this. How about Working for MCA? Let's give everybody a little taste of Lone Star Skynyrd.
Yeah.
All right, there you have it. Working for MCA, the song that Ronnie Van Zant and the band wrote about their beginning of their relationship with their record label and Al Cooper producing them for the first couple of albums. So great job, Stephen. And I got to say, it's just, it gives me chills. And I have a hard time sometimes when I'm playing it in the house or in the car, distinguishing from Lynyrd Skynyrd and Lone Star Skynyrd. That's how incredible you guys are. So great job. You know, the casual music listener, the, you know, the average person out there who isn't a devoted Lynyrd Skynyrd fan like we are, may think that this was just simple, you know, redneck music or, you know, barroom music. And they don't really understand that this is really complex and layered with the three guitars and that incredible piano and the rhythm section with Leon Wilkerson and Bob Burns and then Artemis Pyle on drums. I mean, this was an amazing band doing incredible music that still lasts today. And I don't think people realize it was a mix of what? British rock and boogie woogie and country and gospel and so many influences, like the band Free and the Stones were a huge influence. So this is really complex stuff. How do you guys nail it?
Well, we managed to nail it with lots of hard work and dedication. The guys are excellent musicians, tons of hours put into this, making it perfect. Special attention to detail, close enough, ain't good enough. It has to be perfect.
Talk about your slogan, your mission statement.
Yeah, it's exactly like the record is our mission statement, you know, and we stick tight to that. And if it's not exactly like the record, it ain't right. And that's our test. If we listen back and somebody, is that right? Well, let's listen to it. And if it doesn't sound exactly like it, it's not right. But our guys are awesome. Everybody's tight, you know, and it's just a lot of fun to do. With all the hard work has paid off.
Well, again, this is very complex music with a lot of different musicians. And really, when you think about it, Lynyrd Skynyrd basically started off as a bunch of high school friends in what they called Shantytown in Jacksonville, and they didn't even know how to play. And they worked in the Hell House endlessly day after day after day, got it right. And they became seven virtuosos of what they did. It was really amazing. So how you guys have managed to capture that spirit and the swagger, that attitude, that kind of defiant, you know, cocky, confident attitude that Ronnie and the boys had is just incredible to me. So, but I'm just one guy. I know for a fact that venues have not only had you in to play these great shows, like I want to hear about the Florida show you were telling me about, but promoters have had you back. So what makes these venues and the booking agents have you back?
We're a reliable act. We're reliable on drawing a great crowd, great crowd that goes to the bar over and over.
Not afraid to sip a little, are they?
No, they're not. Skynyrd draws a good crowd for the bar, always. Fun crowd. The crowds are fun. The band's easy to work with. And the music is just like the record, man.
That's it. Tell us about your Florida experience.
Down in Florida, we played Backtoberfest, and this was in October of 2022. Played down there at the Boot Hill Saloon, and that night they had the best crowd, biggest crowd they've had, and the bar did the best they ever did in the 50-year history of the night Lone Star Skynyrd played there.
Fantastic. This music is eternal. I don't think that Ronnie and Gary and Alan and Ed King and the rest of the band knew that it would last this long. I mean, if the Beatles didn't think it would, I can't imagine Skynyrd thought it would last this long. But it has. And this music has taken me through bad times and great times. And I think it's still doing that for everybody today. And you talked about generations of folks. And that's impressive. Generations coming out to these shows you're doing.
Yes, sir. You see, you know, little bitty kids, 8 years old, and like I said with Johnny, people into their 80s, you know, and everybody's digging it. Everybody's dancing, having a good time, just fun to watch. And the, you know, to look out there and see that big of a variation of age, it's really cool, man. And it's all because I love Skynyrd.
And that's why you say when you bring on Lone Star Skynyrd, you bring on the party.
That's exactly right, man.
All right. Speaking of a party, let's deliver just a little sampling of another great Skynyrd classic, an actual true story called I Ain't the One that Ronnie Van Zant and the band turned into a song. Never hurt, sweetheart. Never pull my ear. Here we go. What a great tune. I love this one. And I, you know, I honestly believe Lynyrd Skynyrd never did a song that was even mediocre. And that's another example of a tune that has staying power. I Ain't the One. You heard just a little bit of Lone Star Skynyrd doing I Ain't the One, a true story when Ronnie Van Zant was confronted by a young lady who had a message for him. And that was his. I Ain't the One, baby. Been messing with you. Great job. I'm impressed by the fact that these folks are bringing you back into these venues. And I'm impressed by the fact that you do it exactly like the Lynyrd Skynyrd records, exactly like the record. People may not realize it. I mentioned a few influences a little bit ago, and obviously the Almonds were a big influence on Lynyrd Skynyrd. Some people felt that including the manager of the Almonds and the record label head, Phil Walden, that they were too much like the Almonds. Obviously a lot of similarities, but great big differences. One of which is the Almonds were a jam band. And as you know, Lynyrd Skynyrd played it exactly the same night after night, whether they were in Jacksonville, Florida, or in Tokyo or Germany or wherever else they might've gone, right? It was always the same, and they wanted it tight, and Ronnie wanted it to be like exactly what you heard on the radio. So yes, exactly like the record is pretty cool. So as you talk to venues, you know, obviously we're all in different stages of the journey of life, and there may be some venue managers or entertainment folks who are booking acts who probably wouldn't mind hearing it from your side of things. What suggestions would you make for them to book a successful act at their venue? What do they need to look for from the band point of view?
Well, to make sure they did it successfully, the best place to start would be at LoneStarSkynyrd.com, our website. You can go to the EPK section, and we have stage plot there, backline riders, needed to know about equipment or anything. We got the hospitality riders, anything you need. Song list is there if you want to see what kind of stuff we're playing. We're going to draw a great crowd, so you don't got to worry about that. Mm-hmm. And that would be, if they had any questions, that would be the starting point.
So I'm sure you've heard these folks talking about the egos they have to deal with in the bands and the superstars in their own minds and all that kind of thing. What advice do you have for venues and booking agents?
Yeah, nobody wants to deal with that kind of stuff. You know, local rock stars are always funny. there ain't none of that allowed here. we're all just down to earth DFW guys, you're not going to have to deal with any of that. We're easy to deal with, people, genuine people. This right here, you know, is what you're going to get. Easy to deal with.
Great. Glad to hear that. I tell you what, let's take a little quick break again, just to give folks another sample of what you folks do. One of the biggest songs that even a casual music fan would know. It's been played on the radio since it came out in the 70s, and it's a fantastic song. Again, a true story that Ronnie weaved together with Alan and Gary and the band. And it's Give Me Three Steps. So let's give you a little taste of that from Lone Star Skynyrd.
Might be
There it is. Just a little sampling of Gimme Three Steps, a classic Lynyrd Skynyrd song. But you heard it done by Lone Star Skynyrd. And our guest today is Lone Star Skynyrd lead vocalist, Stephen Naylor. Stephen, I've said it once, I'll say it 1,000 more times. It is unbelievable to me. It's uncanny. I get chills at hearing how you guys truly are, what you say, exactly like the record. Solos are note for note, the singing, the piano playing, the rhythm section. It's incredible. Give Me Three Steps, obviously, as diehards know, was an actual event that happened to Ronnie Van Zant when he was dancing with somebody whose boyfriend was much larger and much meaner. And and it became a terrific song that still cooks today. And you guys do a great representation of that.
Thank you.
You said that Lone Star Skynyrd is more than a tribute and more than a good time party. Tell us what you mean by that.
Well, you know, we're not just checking the box tribute band and that's it. You know, we're dedicated to the Skynyrd catalog, to keeping it exactly like the record, like I mentioned. Yeah, we're dedicated to keeping the Skynyrd music alive, you know, the entire Skynyrd catalog, treating it like a baby, keeping it perfect, exactly like the record. We're dedicated to preserving the spirit of Skynyrd and, you know, taking that live music to the fans and always being there for the promoters and booking agents. We're all in this thing together. So we really want to keep everybody happy is our main goal.
So tell us a little bit about why you say that this year is the year of Lone Star Skynyrd. What's that mean?
We've got the title. We've been around for six. This is our sixth year. So we've won the title and we're taking it out there. We're showing people what Lone Star Skynyrd are all about. We're on a mission this year and we're out to take the band to the masses. We're going to Montana. We're going back to Florida, Alabama, Missouri, possibly back to New Mexico, just taking it everywhere we can take it to get the word out. Year of Lone Star Skynyrd is getting it to the people.
All right, folks, if you just tuned in here, this is Media Done Right from Meteorite Marketing, where we talk to folks that interest us. And we found a very interesting band, and we got a hold of the leader of Lone Star Skynyrd. So lead vocalist Stephen Naylor is with us. Stephen, I think it's time we let people hear another tune that you do so well as Lone Star Skynyrd. This is Lynyrd Skynyrd's classic Saturday Night Special. So let's roll just a little piece of that for the audience.